Chicos, yo creo que va a tener que ser la clase sin video porque me estaban escuchando bien y prendí mi video y me empezaron a decir que me dejaron de escuchar. Entonces, si prendo mi cámara, mi video, ya no me van a escuchar y es más importante que me escuchen a que me vean. ¿Ok? Bueno, vamos a continuar. Lesson B. What time? Y tenemos building vocabulary. Listen and say the time. And we have here, it's 11 o'clock. Okay, let's listen to the audio. This is page, everybody, let's go to page 56. Page 56. You can hear me now, right? Se va el audio. Y se supone que tengo buena señal. Tengo mis 1, 2, 3, 4, mis 4 rayitas. Déjenme. Salgo y entro, ¿ok? Hello, hello. Can you hear me? Chicos, se acabó el coffee break. ¿Me escuchan, chicos? Yes, excelente. Jaime, excelente. ¿Ya me escuchas? Yes, perfect. Okay, yo creo que lo que afectó acá fue la situación que puse o que abrí la cámara. Yo no sé qué problema me está detectando con la cámara. Espero este fin de semana pues adquirir una para porque estoy trabajando desde una laptop, entonces ya viene ahí su cámara integrada y también el micrófono y todo. Pero no sé qué pasa ahora que cuando me da el audio, no me da la cámara, no me deja utilizar la cámara, entonces, o comienzo a tener problemas con mi audio, entonces no sé realmente qué sucede aquí. No sé si sea de la computadora o de la plataforma. Ya ven que ha estado fallando, pero no nos vamos a desesperar, vamos a buscarle una solución, chicos, y vamos a disfrutar nuestra clase, que es lo mejor de todo. Okay, let's start with building vocabulary. Dice, what time in this lesson, en la lesson B, vamos a hablar sobre cómo decir las horas del reloj. Como pueden darse cuenta, tenemos diferentes tipos de clocks. A estos se les dicen clocks, menos a este, porque este es uno de muñeca. Es un reloj de pulsera. Entonces, a ese se le llama watch. Watch es reloj de mano. Y clock es reloj de pared. Es reloj de pared. Ok. Now, let's listen to this building vocabulary. Vamos a escuchar este audio.
Speaking naturally. Word stress. B.
Okay, this is not. Ya tengo miedo de desactivar mi audio. Y ahorita que lo quiera activar otra vez, no pueda. Nayeli, can you hear me? Yes, excellent. Okay, Nayeli, estamos en la page 56, o sea, la página 54. Digo, perdón, 56. Y estamos, vamos a escuchar un audio sobre how to tell the time. Ok, en su casa ya saben, listen and repeat.
What time? 1. Building vocabulary. A. Listen and say the times.
It's 11. It's 11 o'clock. It's 2:05. It's 2:05. It's 4:15. It's 4:15. It's 10:30. It's 6:45. It's 7:15. It's 8:50. It's 10 to 9. It's 12 a.m. It's midnight. It's 12 p.m. It's noon.
Fifty-six. Lesson B. What time? 1. Building vocabulary. A. Listen and say the times.
It's 11. It's 11 o'clock. It's 2:05. It's 2:05. It's 4:15. It's 4:15. It's 10:30. It's 6:45. It's 7:15. It's 8:50. It's 9:10. It's 12 a.m. It's midnight. It's 12 p.m. It's noon.
Okay, those are these times. 12 a.m., midnight, a.m. before 12, noon, and p.m. after 12, it's noon too. Okay, sorry, it's 12 p.m., it's noon, it's 12 a.m., it's midnight. Hello, Carlos, good evening, welcome. I haven't seen you, we're here. Welcome. Okay, we are in page 56. We are in page 56. Lesson B, tell the time. Oh, sorry, what time is it? In this lesson, we're going to talk about telling the time. En esta lección vamos a hablar sobre cómo decir la hora, okay? And we even have here, like for example, when it's en punto, we say 8 o'clock. You see? Well, this is, it's 2:05 or it's 2:05. 2:05, son las 2:05. You see, it's 4:15, it's 4:15. Es lo que decimos en español, son las 4:15, ¿no? O las 3:15, o sea, las 3:15. It's, se dice muy parecido. It's 4:15. Son las 4:15. It's 10:30. You see, or half an hour. También se dice half an hour, pero aquí no lo tenemos. Dice, it's 6:45. Se puede leer también la hora así de corrido. It's 6:45. O sea, es 7:15. That's how you say it. It's 8:50 or it's 8:50. Son 9:10. It's 8:50. It's 12 a.m. Medianoche. It's 12 p.m. It's noon. It's mediodía. Now says pair work. Take turns asking and telling the time. And we have what time is it? It's 2:15. It's 2:15. Etc. Okay, we're going to work on this on Friday, okay? Y no crean que se me ha olvidado. ¿Se acuerdan que tenemos un reading por ahí pendiente? Bueno, ese Friday. ¡Ah! No se me ha olvidado. Bueno, This Friday vamos a hacer ese reading, lo van a leer y vamos a hacer esta actividad, ¿ok? Para que la vayan estudiando. Page 56, Exercise B, Pair Work. ¿Ok? Para que no se los olvide. Now, we have, in conversation, people say hour, 15 more. Like, for example, ahorita, ¿no? Por ejemplo, it's 7:15 more. Then a quarter after hour. 2:15, a quarter after 2. You see? It's more irregular. It's more common to hear that answer. Es más común escuchar ese 2:15, por ejemplo, 2:15, 2:15, que it's a quarter after 2. Okay? Now, listen. What's on... Okay, listening, sorry. What's on this weekend? And we have some exercises there, right? And we have the instructions that says, how often do you go to events like this? Tell the class, then listen to the radio show and complete the chart. Okay, and we have some events there. A concert, art exhibit, soccer match, and a play. A play is like, for example, en el teatro. Cuando vas al teatro y ves una obra de teatro, that is a play. Eso es un play, okay? So, can you tell me how you go to this event? To a concert, to an art exhibit, to soccer match, or to a play? Tell me right here. Right here in the chat. Carlos, I thought that you were going to answer me. Creí que ibas a contestar. Who can answer me? How often do you go to a concert? For example, I never go to concerts. I don't know. I don't really like them. Oh, Carlos, you never go to concerts. High five. Chocolas. High five. Yeah, me neither. I don't like them. I don't know why. Okay, to an art exhibit, I actually go to art exhibit whenever I can. Okay, how about you? Yeah, I like to go to art exhibits. Like, for example, to the one that, the one about, what is the name of, Tim Burton? El extraño mundo de Tim Burton. Es una art exhibit que se dio en el Museo de México de Antropología e Historia. I went to that one. También fui a la de los cascos de la NFL. No, los toros de la NFL, ¿cuándo fue? Ya, eran toros de la NFL, I guess. Hace unos años, También fui, that it's an art exhibit too. What else? Which one is the, is another one? You always go to concerts even. Very good. When they brought also to, when they brought also I was going to tell you something else. No, era una art exhibit a Carlos acerca de que hace unos años se puso muy de moda unos toros, toros ya sabes, con este con flores y o sea, era una exposición de toros, pero todos los toros eran temáticos. No, no, wait. Eran dos, fueron dos diferentes, perdón. Una fue de la NFL que tienen sus este tenían sus cascos y la otra es la de los toros. Ay, I wish I could remember the name. Pero eran unos toros que pusieron muchos toros por la Ciudad de México. ¿O vacas? ¿Eran vacas? Pero, o sea, esto no fue ahorita, fue hace algún tiempo. Sí, no, o sea, haz de cuenta, era como una estatua del toro, ¿no? Y a la estatua del toro le dibujaban ciertas cosas, ¿no? Por ejemplo, temáticas principalmente. Como este botánica, o sea, flores, como si fuera cajita de Olinalá, y otras ponían este cosas de la electricidad, ¿no? Y hacían un toro como con cables. Pero no recuerdo cómo se llamaba esa exhibición. Y me acuerdo que hicieron, yo me acordaba que habían hecho una parecida de la NFL, pero al parecer no solamente fueron esos. Pero de verdad, desearía darme de luz. ¿Cómo se llamaban los benditos toros? O no sé si eran vacas. Pero eran un bovino. I go to art exhibits and the Warhol the last year. I go to soccer match twice a week. Ah, twice a year. Okay. And to a play? Never, okay. Yeah, I do. I go to plays every 6 months or so. Okay. Jaime, Nayeli, what about you? Tell me. ¿Lo traen a la exhibición de objetos romanos o del Antiguo Egipto y así? Y fíjate que no me ha comentado nada, ¿eh? Yo creo que no, me parece que está pasando por una situación ahora sí que personal. Ella me comenta que se va a poner al corriente, pero yo creo que hoy no se va a conectar con nosotros. Okay. I go to play Rey León last year. Okay. I went. Fui. I went. I went. Fui. Really? Rey León. That's great. Creo que también la Illusion on Ice de la que sacan en Mundo Imperial también podría contar como una play. Okay. And says, here we have another question. Where is it? What time, sorry, does it start? Okay, now let's listen. Go to our. Okay, I go. But it says how often, like, I go to an art exhibit twice a year. How often? ¿Qué tan seguido? ¿O 3 times a year, or one time a year, or only once a month, or once a year, etc. Okay. I go to rock concert in the Zócalo of Mexico. It starts from 7 in the afternoon. Ah, okay. These questions are for the listening, okay? Nosotros solamente tenemos que decir how often. ¿Qué tan seguido vamos a estos eventos? Concerts, art exhibit. ¿Con qué frecuencia vamos a esos eventos? Por ejemplo, a un concert. Ya te pones a hacer memoria. Ah, pues más o menos como every 2 or 3 years, or every year I go to a concert to Mexico, etc. Okay. Rabat's last year. Great. That's interesting. Very good. Okay, now let's listen to the out. Let's listen to the listening.
Listening. What's on this weekend? Listen to the radio show and complete the chart.
Hi, everybody. You're listening to KYMZ on 98.6. My name is Ross Williams. So, what's on this weekend? Okay, now on Saturday night, there's a children's concert at the park. There's music, dancing, and games. Sounds like a lot of fun. The concert starts at 5:30 p.m. So that's 5:30 p.m. tomorrow at the park. On Sunday, there's an art exhibit at the museum all afternoon. The exhibit is called Computer Crazy. There's work from local artists, so go down to the museum on Sunday. It starts at 12 noon. That's 12 o'clock on Sunday. Okay, soccer fans, listen up. The 3 o'clock match on Saturday at the stadium is now at 3:30. That's 3:30, there at the stadium. Finally, if you like theater, go and see the play, Are You Okay? It's on Saturday night, the City Theater. They say it's very funny. It starts at 7:45. So, have a great weekend, folks. There's a lot to do in town here this weekend.
listening. What's on this weekend? Listen to the radio show and complete the chart.
Hi, everybody. You're listening to KYMZ on 98.6. My name is Ross Williams. So, what's on this weekend? Okay, now on Saturday night, there's a children's concert at the park. There's music, dancing, and games. Sounds like a lot of fun. The concert starts at 5:30 p.m. So that's 5:30 p.m. tomorrow at the park. On Sunday, there's an art exhibit at the museum all afternoon. The exhibit is called Computer Crazy. There's work from local artists, so go down to the museum on Sunday. It starts at 12 noon. That's 12 o'clock on Sunday. Okay, soccer fans, listen up. The 3 o'clock match on Saturday at the stadium is now at 3:30. That's 3:30. There at the stadium. Finally, if you like theater, go and see the play, Are You Okay? It's on Saturday night at the City Theater. They say it's very funny. It starts at 7:45. So, have a great weekend, folks. There's a lot to do in town here this weekend.
You want to listen it one more time? Yes, right? Híjoles. Lo puedo poner otra vez, con voz más clara no lo puedo poner, pero lo puedo poner otra vez, definitivamente. ¿Ok? Diría el tri, súbele a la radio.
Listening. What's on this weekend? Listen to the radio show and complete the chart.
Hi, everybody. You're listening to KYMZ on 98.6. My name is Ross Williams. So, what's on this weekend? Okay, now on Saturday night, there's a children's concert at the park. There's music, dancing, and games. Sounds like a lot of fun. The concert starts at 5:30 p.m. So that's 5:30 p.m. tomorrow at the park. On Sunday, there's an art exhibit at the museum all afternoon. The exhibit is called Computer Crazy. There's work from local artists, so go down to the museum on Sunday. It starts at 12 noon. That's 12 o'clock on Sunday. Okay, soccer fans, listen up. The 3 o'clock match on Saturday at the stadium is now at 3:30. That's 3:30. There at the stadium. Finally, if you like theater, go and see the play, Are You Okay? It's on Saturday night at the City Theater. They say it's very funny. It starts at 7:45. So, have a great weekend, folks. There's a lot to do in town here this weekend.
How can you believe that? No. Okay, do you want me to play it again? Yes, faltan otras 7 veces. Okay. This is the last time, okay? Listen at it for one last time, una última vez. This is the last time. No logras entenderlo todo. Es como que un programa de radio, right? Porque estás hecho así como que una musiquita. Just check your answers. No necesitas entenderlo todo para sacar tus...
Listening. What's on this weekend? Listen to the radio show and complete the chart.
Hi, everybody. You're listening to KYMZ on 98.6. My name is Ross Williams. So, what's on this weekend? Okay, now on Saturday night, there's a children's concert at the park. There's music, dancing, and games. Sounds like a lot of fun. The concert starts at 5:30 p.m. So that's 5:30 p.m. tomorrow at the park. On Sunday, there's an art exhibit at the museum all afternoon. The exhibit is called Computer Crazy. There's work from local artists, so go down to the museum on Sunday. It starts at 12 noon. That's 12 o'clock on Sunday. Okay, soccer fans, listen up. The 3 o'clock match on Saturday at the stadium is now at 3:30. That's 3:30, there at the stadium. Finally, if you like theater, go and see the play, Are You Okay? It's on Saturday night at the City Theater. They say it's very funny. It starts at 7:45. So, have a great weekend, folks. There's a lot to do in town here this weekend.
Okay, maybe. Tal vez entre todos nosotros. Between all of us, or working together, we can get this information right. Podemos tener este reading o este listening, perdón, con sus respuestas correctas. Okay, el concert. ¿Quién tiene las respuestas del concert? When? Where is it? In the park. What? Sorry. In the park, at what time? At what time, Carlos? Five thirty p.m. Very good. Very good. Next one, an art exhibit. Carlos, we're going to wait for your classmates. Vamos a esperar a que tus compañeros también comenten algo. Okay, yes. Iré a ver una película de 2 horas mientras. Okay, Carlos. Chicos, hello. Help me with the answers. Ayúdenme con las respuestas. No le entendí el audio esta vez. Será radio escucha. Okay, Nayeli, Jaime, how about you? Jaime dijo, sayonara. Okay, Nayeli. Yes, I know. Nayeli. Okay. Jaime, it's on again. Nayeli. The art exhibit. Nobody. ¿7 p.m.? Ah, okay, don't worry. Okay, the soccer match. How about the soccer match? At the stadium, of course, right? At the stadium, at what time? At 3:30, right? 2:30 a.m. or p.m.? Right. Of course. It would be odd, right? A.M. Sería raro un partido a las 3 de la mañana. Well, que actually there are, right? Hay algunos. Me ha tocado que luego me comentan que el partido es a la 1 de la mañana, principalmente del Barcelona o de algo así. Yeah, right, okay. But well, if you're going to go to the stadium, si vas a ir al estadio, bueno, normalmente no lo van a poner a las 3 de la mañana, right? Okay, a play. You don't understand that? Okay, at the city theater. At what time? Forty-five, right? 7:45. Oh. 45. There it is. PM. One more time. Okay, please check your answers. Chequen sus respuestas and let me know when you're ready so we can go to the next page. Okay, ready, Carlos? Let's wait for the review. Okay, who else? Iván and Carlos are ready. Jaime and Ayeli, are you ready? Okay, ready. Perfect. Okay, let's go to the next page, to the next exercise. Says, building language. Listen, what time is the concert? Then practice the conversation. Okay, one more time, we have another listening. Tenemos otro listening, but in this case, ya tenemos parte de el tape script, right? Tenemos la conversación ya ahí escrita para saber lo que dice y e ir siguiendo la conversation. So, what I'm going to ask you, lo que les voy a pedir es que por favor la vayan haciendo ustedes en casa. Remember, we're going to do it twice. La vamos a hacer dos veces, okay? So you can listen and repeat. If there is any other word, si hay alguna palabra que no entiendan, please write me in the chat. Escríbanme en el chat para que yo les comente a qué se refiere, okay?
Building language. A. Listen. What time is the concert?
Hey, there's a free jazz concert tomorrow night.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Where?
At Grant Park.
What time does it start?
It starts at 7.
Okay, well, let's go. Let's meet at the park at 6:45.
But they don't usually have a lot of seats, so...
Oh, well, in that case, let's get there early. Say around 6:30.
Building language. A. Listen. What time is the concert?
Hey, there's a free jazz concert tomorrow night.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Where?
At Grant Park.
What time does it start?
It starts at 7.
Okay, well, let's go. Let's meet at the park at 6:45.
But they don't usually have a lot of seats, so...
Oh, well, in that case, let's get there early. Say around 6:30.
Okay, let's continue. Sorry, there it is. Okay, says complete the suggestions with verbs. Have a conversation with a partner. And we have let's to a movie tomorrow. Let's coffee together after class. Which verb would you use to complete this question? Sorry, these sentences. Type it here in the chat. Let's watch no No, no sería Let's Watch. Let's go movie tomorrow. Use the examples in the conversation. Let's go to a movie tomorrow. And the other one? Oh, sorry. Let's go to a movie tomorrow. Okay, I'm going to give you a clue. Here we have suggestions. Let's go, let's meet, let's get. Let's meet at 7 to a movie tomorrow. Let's go. Vamos. Let's go to a movie tomorrow. Let's go to a movie tomorrow. Let's get coffee. Very good. Let's get coffee together after class. Oh, sorry. Okay, now let's go to grammar. Telling time suggestions with let. What time is it? What time does the concert start? What time do supermarkets close, sorry. What time do you go out at night? It's 6:30. It starts at 9 o'clock. At about 10 p.m., usually around 8 or 8:30. Suggestions: let's go, let's meet at 6:45, let's get there early. Now, let's get coffee together after class. Okay, sorry. Invitation. You can ask people you don't know. Excuse me, do you have the time? Esto es para preguntarle la hora a una persona que tú no conoces. Excuse me, do you have the time? Write the questions with what time, then ask three classmates your questions. You see, you have to transform this into questions. Tienen que transformar esto en pregunta. Tienen que utilizar what time. Okay? What time? Type your answers here. Me escriben sus respuestas aquí, en el chat. De la number 2 a la number 6. Fourth. Ah, oh, okay, you won the board. Yes, it's funny, right? When we get the board. Es más entretenido, right? Con el y pueden escribir todos a la vez. Okay, go ahead. I already click on collaborate, or I'm sharing already with you the board. Ya estoy compartiendo con ustedes el board. You may, tal vez no puedan consultar el grammar chart, pero ustedes lo tienen en su libro. So, there is no problem. No entendiste. Ah, ok. Estoy abriendo el board para que aquí puedan transformar esas oraciones que tienen ahí, esas sentences, en preguntas. You have to ask. What time or at what time? Okay, tienen que investigar a qué horas se llevarán a cabo esas acciones que ven ustedes ahí. Estoy abriendo el board para que ustedes puedan trabajar todos juntos. Go ahead. Así como en el ejemplo, find out what time, y ahí tienes. They get home on Saturday night. Y la pregunta es, what time do you get home on Saturday night? ¿Sí? ¿Quién es color black? ¿Quiere que lo haga un poco más pequeño? Do you want me to? Iván, mira, para que no desaparezcas, ya ahorita que estás así, acá, what time do you leave work or school in the afternoon? Acuérdate que para que sea pregunta debe de llevar el signo de interrogación. ¿Ok? Iván, sigue escribiendo en el mismo cuadrito. Mira, aquí nada más al final le das Enter y ya te da otro espacio, ¿ya viste? Ok, Nayeli, te voy a hacer un poquito más pequeña, ¿ok? Para que no tengas que cortar tu sentence. Ahí está, Nayeli. Continue. We're going to wait for the rest. Vamos a esperar a los demás. Ok, chicos, les comienzo a revisar su trabajo. Ahora sí. Ya solo falta uno. Okay, Naye es el pink, el black. ¿De quién es el black? De Iván, ¿no? Este es Iván, right? Y Carlos en Jaime, right? Okay. Excellent. What time do you leave work or school in the afternoon? What time does local supermarket open and close? Does the local, aquí le tienes que poner, the local supermarket open and close. Ya este ya no, acuérdate, si ya afecta a tu verbo, a este, al does, ya no afecta al demás. A los demás. What time does your favorite TV show start? What time does your... What? Your favorite TV show starts? What time does last train leave their local station? A ver, what time? What time does the last train leave the local station? What time do buses start running in the morning? Okay. What time do you leave work or school in the afternoon? What time does the local supermarket open and close? Una vez más, open and close. Open and close. And close. What time does their favorite TV... Do buses, porque es plural, do buses start running at the morning? Oh, can you hear me? ¿Me escuchan? Can you hear me? Yes, okay, great. Les estaba comentando, ya no es opens and closes porque ya le pusimos acá, esa regla ya afectó al verbo auxiliar, ya tenemos does. Cuando tenemos does, ya no necesitamos ponerle la S. Acuérdense que solo funciona en la tercera persona singular. Si es plural así como buses, ya no le tengo que poner el does. Le pongo el do y ya no le tengo que poner S a ninguno de los verbos. What time does their favorite TV show start? Una vez más, le tendrían que poner S si no tuvieran acá el does. Pero como lo tienen, ya no le tienen que poner la S aquí al start. What time does the last train leave their local station? Está bien. What time do buses start running in the mornings? Muy bien, porque dice buses, es plural. Entonces, lleva do, no does. Okay, what time do you leave work or school? Nayeli, voy con Nayeli. What time do you leave work or school in the afternoon? What time do you... ¿Puede abrir el board, please, para copiar mis respuestas? Yes. Wait. Espera, Carlos. What time does your your local supermarket. Okay. Time does your local time does your porque le estás preguntando a ellos. ¿Viste? Okay, una vez más, what time does your local supermarket open and close? What time does your favorite TV show start? What time does the last train leave their local station? What time do buses start running in the morning? Very good, Nayem. What time do you leave work or school in the afternoon? What time does your local, una vez más, your local supermarket open and close? What time does your favorite? Acuérdense que your también significa plural. Your favorite TV show start. What time do the last train leave their local station? Leave, sin ese. What time do buses start running in the morning? Okay, there you are. Ready? Okay, let me know when you're ready, when you check your answers, so we can continue to the next exercise. Okay, ready, Ivan is ready. Carlos is ready, I guess. Okay, ready. Naye, Jaime, let me know when you're ready. Ready. Okay, excellent. Let's continue then. Let's go to the next page. Vocabulary notebook. Yes, as a homework. Homework. The homework, ya saben. The second part of unit 5 in the workbook. Y yo ya le envié toda la noche. Great. Okay. Y esta. Page 62. Okay, page 62. For a new way to log and learn vocabulary. That is your homework. Okay, esa es su tarea. Esa es su tarea, chicos, para el día de Friday. Okay, let's go to lesson C. It's a great place to live. Like Acapulco, right? Acapulco, it's a great place to live. Es un gran lugar para vivir, Acapulco. Right. Okay. Conversation strategy. Ah, this is good one. Carlos, ¿por qué esos puntos? Of course, Acapulco is a great place to live. Si dejas de lado todo lo malo, of course. Why not? ¿Ya ves? ¿Nayeli extraña el calor? Lo que pasa, Nayeli, es que no apreciamos lo que tenemos cuando lo tenemos, sino hasta que lo perdemos. When you move to another place, cuando te mudas hacia otro lugar, ya es que te das cuenta. We live in a paradise, actually. Vivimos en un paraíso. Los que vivimos en Acapulco. Bueno, no entremos en política. Ya, podemos ir a la playita en cuanto quieramos. Yeah, that's a great, it's a great advantage. Se siente feo cuando ya no vives en Acapulco y dices, ay, quiero ir a la playita, y te das cuenta que faltan 6 meses para tus vacaciones. Y mientras haces con esas ganas de ir a la playita, con esa hambre de la vitamina D. Me pasa eso, Miss. Yes, exacto. ¿Ves? Así como Iván. Nada que como los... Ay, tengo ganas de ir a la playa. Me voy a echar un café y me voy a llevar un sándwich y me voy a ir a la playa. ¡Vamos a la playa! What's the deal? Okay, conversation strategy. This is a great strategy. Me too and me neither. Esto no sé por qué le causa mucha confusión. O le causa, perdón, no mucha confusión, pero le causa confusión a mucha gente. Me too es como yo también. And me neither es yo tampoco. Okay, like for example, ahorita que les estoy diciendo que it's a great place to live, y me dice Iván, ¿me pasa eso, Miss? Y yo le respondo, oh, me too. ¿Viste? Deberíamos hacer una practice exercise with the tourists. Yeah. Well, I don't know, maybe. Okay, I love our neighborhood. Me too or me neither. I don't like the new movie theater. Me too o me neither. Okay. Estas dos, me too and me neither, shows agreement, se le llama. ¿Qué quiere decir eso? Que muestran agreement, concordancia, o sea, concuerdas con esa persona. Ojo, el me too es afirmativa. Okay? Neither es negativa. O sea, que si mi oración está en affirmative, me too. Pero si mi oración está en negative form, voy a utilizar me neither. ¿Ok? Okay, says, now listen, what do you find out about this neighborhood? Okay, bueno, Carlos ya me dio sus respuestas allá. Dice, I love our neighborhood. Yes, it's me too, así como les digo. Como nuestra oración, esta oración está en affirmative, vamos a concordar con me too. Pero, por ejemplo, aquí que está en negative, we're going to show agreement con me neither, que es A. Says, now listen, what do you find out about this neighborhood? Okay, let's listen. B A, yes, B A. Okay. Let's listen.
Be a great place to live. 1. Conversation strategy. Me too, and me neither. Listen, what do you find out about this neighborhood?
I just love this neighborhood.
Me too. I bet it's a great place to live.
Yeah, it has some great restaurants.
Right, but they're expensive.
Yeah, I know. There are a lot of rich people around here.
Well, I'm not rich.
No, me neither.
By the way, are you hungry? I'm starving.
Me too. But let's eat somewhere else. It's kind of expensive around here.
Great place to live. 1. Conversation strategy. Me too and me neither. Listen, what do you find out about this neighborhood?
I just love this neighborhood.
Me too. I bet it's a great place to live.
Yeah. It has some great restaurants.
Right. But they're expensive.
Yeah, I know. There are a lot of rich people around here.
Well, I'm not rich.
No, me neither.
By the way, are you hungry? I'm starving.
Me too. But let's eat somewhere else. It's kind of expensive around here.
It's expensive, right? They have to find out another restaurant. Because that one is expensive. Right, it's a nice place to live, but it's also very expensive to eat. Okay, Nadia's helmet and Jessica say me too and me neither to show they have something in common. Find examples in the conversation. I just love this neighborhood. Me too. Which other expression do we have like this? Otra expresión en donde haya contestado me too or me neither. I'm starving, me too. Another one? Another one. There is a negative one there. We have a negative agreement there, right? We have me too and me neither. Ya me dijiste tú, Ele, I just love this neighborhood, me too. Y el otro de, I'm starving, let's eat, me too. Pero hay uno donde dice me neither. I'm not rich. Yes, very good. Me neither. No, me neither. Okay. Make true sentences about your neighborhood. Circle an expression or add your own. Tenemos, I live in an exciting or boring or a great neighborhood. Okay. I'm going to open the board so you can make sentences about your own neighborhood, okay? So, ninguna puede ser igual y a la vez puede haber algunas que coincidan, pero you have to write about your own neighborhood. Open the board. I already share with you, right? Ya le había dado en share, en collaborate. There it is. Now, let's collaborate. Go ahead. Start writing 5 sentences about your own neighborhood. Let me make you a little bit smaller, Naye. There you are. Oh, not Naye. There it is. Okay. We are waiting for Nayeli and Jaime. Meanwhile, I'm checking Van and Carlos, okay? I live, I like the houses in my neighborhood. I don't like the restaurant here. I don't like the restaurants in my neighborhood. I don't like the restaurants here, sorry. I go to a lot of movies in my neighborhood. Órale. I have never visto ese I go to a lot of movies. Well, that is the example. I don't go shopping then. Okay, very good. I live in a great neighborhood. Carlos, the stores in my neighborhood. I don't like the streets. I don't eat out there. Okay. Naye, I live in a great neighborhood. I like the stores in the neighborhood a lot. Yeah, but here is optional. Look, here is optional. Go shopping, you see? I don't eat out. Okay, I live in a great neighborhood. I like the stores. In my neighborhood, I don't like the buildings there. I go to a lot of movies in my neighborhood. I don't go shopping there. Okay, very good. I don't go shopping there. I live in a great neighborhood. I like the houses in my neighborhood. I don't like restaurants there. I go to a lot of movies in my neighborhood. I don't go shopping there. Very good. Okay. Do you have any questions so far? ¿Tienen una duda, chicos? Hasta ahorita. Because if not, then we will finish the class. No. Carlos, no me grites. Ya te estás vengando, ¿verdad, Carlos? Porque te gritas en